our dad's childhood in Homewood. He would tell us how our granddad and Grandma Buckley took in his grandma, Grandma Buck, along with Uncle Jim, Uncle Ed, Uncle Joe, and even cousins Eleanor and Mary when times got hard. They all lived together in the big house. But according to Dad, they never wanted for anything. There was always food on the table, scraps for whatever stray dog that our grandma took in, and clean clothes. And there were family parties with singing and dancing and talent shows. Believe me, when he was done telling his tales, we were left thinking, why wasn't I born during the Great Depression? Then there were the tales of Jimmy Buckley skipping school to take in a baseball game with one of his favorite uncles at Ford's Field, or Jimmy Buckley spotted jumping between the rooftops in the alleys. Grandkids, don't take any ideas from that. Or the calls throughout the neighborhood that Jimmy Buckley was missing again as he sailed over the hills of Pittsburgh on his bike, usually arriving unannounced at the door of a relative. Truly, he was the Huckleberry Finn of Homewood. As a teen and a young man, he did what any good Irish Catholic guy did. He ran with the boys at Clancy's Bar in the Brighton Inn on Saturdays, and he sang in the church choir on Sundays. And then he met our mom. Yes, at the Brighton Inn, Mom and Fred had come from playing bingo at St. Cyril's across the street, and Dad told me that he summoned up the courage to go and speak with her. She was, and is, the love of his life. And here we sit now, 59 years of marriage later, and 5 kids later. Our dad was solid in a way that defines his generation. A man of his word, loyal, hardworking, truthful, and yes, a bit black and white. Even when we didn't agree with him, we always knew where he stood and respected him for it. He will always be remembered for his jokes and his stories and his twinkling Irish eyes. But I would also like to share with you some of the gifts that our dad shared with us. From our dad, we received the importance of hard work. I don't ever recall our dad missing a day of work. To his sons, grandsons, and great-grandsons, he shared his love of fishing and hunting. Dad hunted with Stephen and his grandson Kyle until he was 86 years old. To his daughters and some parts of his grandchildren, he shared his love of music. Thanks to our dad, we grew up revering Rodgers and Hammerstein musicals and loving big band music. To all of us, he said, if only to yourself be true, giving us all the moral compass that we would need throughout our lives. But above all, we learned from Dad the gift and value of family. Whether they were deceased or living, family was so important to Dad. He was the self-proclaimed family historian, the keeper of the stories. It occurred to me in later years that, like any good storyteller, Dad shared stories so often because he wanted them to be passed down from generation to generation. He wanted those that went before him, the Buckleys, the Pritchards, the Sherrys, to be remembered and honored for the difference that they made not only in his life, but in the lives of so many people sitting here today. And within his own family, he loved everyone else unconditionally.